This is a watercolor video for my seventh grade class. We're working on a fish composition, so it looks like a school of fish. And we've already drawn our fish on there. There, you can leave your fish just in pencil and paint, or you can outline them with a Sharpie if you'd like. Or this one, I used a white crayon, and I'm going to just show you the difference in painting a crayon resist. You can choose. I don't recommend mixing it. I just did this for your benefit. We're going to use these Crayola semi-moist pans. First thing you want to do is put some water in your colors. So I'm just dripping it on my colors to let them soften up a little bit. You don't have to do all of them. You can just mostly do the ones that you know you're going to be using. And let them start getting to a pretty good consistency there. Watercolors need lots of water. That's why they call them watercolors. Now, this is one I did using a wet-on-wet technique, and I think I'll show you how to do that as well. Also, we have used a little resist here and dropped some alcohol on it. So we're going to do a background that has an interesting technique that you'll be able to choose as well. Now I decided I wanted my fish to be colored like this, and I want to show you how to blend these colors as well. So I'm going to start off with some yellow, and watercolor paint is not supposed to look like your tempera. Or your, like if you look at the picture I'm going from, it has yellow up here. The more water you put with a color, the lighter it's going to be. So what I'm going to do is just try to, there's sort of an under layer of color there, of yellow, even under the orange. And this kind of gets green. Now if I want that to get a little bit lighter, I'm just going to dip my brush in water, maybe a little bit more, and just bring this down, and it'll get lighter as I get towards the edge. Now when I look at my picture, I do not see much yellow over here. You probably don't want to color the whole fish yellow unless you see, or whatever under color it is there. Because if you paint purple on top of yellow, you're going to get brown, and that is not what we're going for. So now I'm going to get my brush swished out clean, wipe some of this off, and then with a brush that's kind of a little bit wet, I'm going to just what we call feather this in so it just looks like it blends and gradually gets white. Okay. Get my brush clean again. Now make sure you use watercolor brushes. You don't want to get an acrylic brush or a flat brush that's stiff with lots of stiff bristles. All right, now I'm going to come back here with a little bit of the orange. I see this lighter orange. Somebody has got some brown in here or black, but I think we can make this work. And I'm just going to put this right over top of where I just painted that. I want to be careful. I don't want it so much up there on the top part. And I'm just going to take this where, and keep looking at your painting. You don't want to just, I mean, we're trying to do some realism with these. If you want a little bit darker, you can go back in there. You don't want to keep scrubbing over and over and over, or your paper, even though we're using a pretty good watercolor paper, your paper will start getting like it's coming apart, little balls of paper up on it. So you don't want to do that. So don't ever scrub. Now if you get too much on it, I should have brought me a paper towel over here. You can get a nice dry brush and you can just kind of roll this over there and pick up some, or just paint it lightly and take some of this off if you think you've got too much on there. Okay, now I'm going to try to find a, this is almost like a neon color, which I don't have. I think I'll go with this next color is a darker orange. Maybe I'll put a little bit of that on here, right up at the edge. Now, all of my fish in this school are going to be painted the same way, so you need to kind of remember what you're doing so that you'll do it for each fish. That could have been a little bit darker. There you go. And I kind of like that mottled kind of look, because when you look really close at the picture here, it kind of has that look. Here. And your brush. Now they have a pink, so I'm not sure if I'm going to use some of this pink and then go into purple. Let's see. A little more red there. No, it's not the color. Now I do have some liquid watercolors, Blick, that have that pink matter, that rose matter that we're looking for here. And you can use those if you'd like. The only problem that I have with them sometimes is that they don't seem to hold the color long. They have a tendency to fade. But if you want to use those, they're a lot more vibrant than what we have here. Now I'm going to go here to the purple, and I want to put some purple. Kind of like a rainbow fish here, isn't it? And you can just paint right over that part. And it almost even has a little bit of blue, the eyes blue. And then a little bit under the fins blue. Now you have to be really careful if you don't want the colors to run together. See, I've got puddles of color there. So I can kind of pick up a little bit of that if I want to. Or I could just leave it for a texture. One thing you don't want to do is pick up your paper and turn it up this way, or everything's going to run. And you really don't want that. So it's better to leave it flat. Now, when you get ready to do something small, you might want to get a smaller brush. This is a blue here. It's sort of a turquoise blue for the eye. So I'm going to go inside here and paint that. I'm not painting that white part around it, because if I did, it's going to change color. But I did notice there's some of this here at the bottom. So I'm going to go along here and just put a little bit of that color. It's going to make it a little bit darker. And then we've got some green. Oops, I didn't get enough paint on that. A little bit of green on the fins here. More than I want, so I'm going to try to get rid of some of that. So you can, while it's, you can blend that in. The tips of the tail here have some green. I don't know that I want this green and this orange to combine, because that's not going to make a very nice color. I might go ahead and take a dry brush and try to pick up some of that. So I can take a dry brush and try to lift some of this out and take it back in there. Okay. Get back over here to this, the tips of the fins here. But paint slowly. I say that all the time, don't I? It's probably because I want you to talk less and paint more. And maybe here. Okay. Now each fish you'll try to paint is pretty close to the same. Again, if you want to get that dry brush and, whoops, clean it first. And pick pick up some of this if you got too much. Mine's a little more than I wanted there. Okay, and that's one of them finished. I'll go around here with a little more purple right here. But use a couple different size brushes, and once you get one fish done, then you can move over to another one. Some people like to paint them like an assembly line, one section at a time, but I think if you're going to be blending the colors, you might want to just do one fish and then move to the next fish and try to make it as pretty as you can. And we'll worry about the background in another tutorial. Thank you, and I hope you have fun painting your fish composition.